you're not going to believe what he's able to keep alive. And that's what we're going to enjoy watching from these two.
Absolutely.
And Nesto's got the softest hands. Watch, folks, when you see them him getting blasted, there's nobody I've seen better. Take that in, soften it, right back in the non-volley zone. You will see that today from Ernesto. I mean, it's incredible what he can do.
Big man with soft hands.
Yeah, very well said.
So just a little side note, I ran into Ernesto this morning on the way in at 9:30. He said, Scott, I'm going to win the gold medal today. He predicted
that's
it.
Funny.
Well, you know, I said the same thing.
I did too, actually.
Every high-level athlete has to believe that.
Agreed.
Now, it doesn't always happen the way they want it to, but they go in believing that it can happen, that it will happen.
Right, it's not cocky, it's just...
Well, it's a mindset.
Cocky and a mindset. Exactly.
If you don't have that confidence going in, you're not going to win the goal for sure.
Absolutely.
See, this is a little bit of gamesmanship to start with, even where everybody's strength and weaknesses are right in the way.
Have these two teams squared off yet today?
No.
Not yet.
Oh, this is going to be great, man. This is, like you said, it's a feeling out process right now.
You got a lot of athleticism on this court.
I love Aspen's ability to just push through those balls so solid.
Yeah.
He's just very methodical with his attack shot.
He's got a very compact backswing. Extends right through it for some extra power.
You know, and we don't get a ton of emotion out of him, but he's always dialed in, it seems like. Aspen never seems to be looking at the ceiling or, you know, he's very focused when he's playing.
Absolutely. He's unflappable.
Look at that follow. But see, even there.
By the way, when you're talking about Kern, I mean, look at the slice. I mean, you don't realize it. You cannot realize it watching this on the video, how much power he's putting out with that slice. That is a very difficult shot to hit.
Cuts that ball.
Very difficult.
Derek Prince, our referee, in this one. Nice.
Man, that is just too good right there for Aspen Kern.
Oh, he set that up beautifully.
But you know, you would never know, look at him, if he hit that winner or if he hit it into the net. Like, he doesn't show you that emotion that a lot of players play, but that's what keeps him so steady through all these matches.
Steady Eddie.
No wasted
that's for
energy.
Sure.
No wasted energy there.
Don't call it deadpan.
Got a great crowd. Look at this crowd. So into it. Oh, that's
yeah,
you
unusual.
Can't put that ball
I haven't
up
seen
there.
That did not happen in the earlier match. That was unusual to see that.
They were not giving up opportunities
right.
Like that.
Early on, there's a hole in that middle they got to fix right now. That's what we're seeing. Aspen and Rob able to take advantage of some of that middle.
3-0-2 is our score. Nicely done.
Yeah.
I mean, Aspen just froze Matthew and Ernesto. They had no idea where he was going with that ball.
Yeah, he moved that ball so well.
Wow.
Oh, we got it.
Nearly.
Slip.
Good effort. Clipped Ernesto on that return.
Got it.
Line judge called it good.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, I mean, Rob Cassie made the call for him, said it was in.
You know, that's the line judge. Me. I don't know about you guys. I would have taken a timeout after that fall. What if we grouped down 0-5? 4-0-5-0. Yeah, I would have taken a timeout.
I agree.
Skid. Bang, 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 bang.
Again, I mean, nobody understands. I mean, you're looking at Aspen's watching this, and that backhand slice across court is just crazy.
Yeah, that's what he's known for. That cross court slice.
Right? That is just crazy.
That cross court slice is what Aspen's been known for.
Oh, wow. That's a great, move.
Retrieve that ball for the players here. Is our score.
Okay, look at that.
Bang.
Oh my goodness.
Matthew is up high in the air for that
one. The problem is you got that slice, right? And he just changed it right up just a little bit to flick. I mean, that was the thing that just caught him off guard. They haven't seen that all day today.
Love the skies.
Look at that.
Wow, a little let court help.
Hands, right?
For Ernesto right there.
I think you're going to see a little more lobbying. This group did not, there was not a lot of lobbying against Ernesto earlier in the earlier match. So that could cause a little bit of freezing up at the net. Yeah. Side unfortunately, out. That was a non-attack of the ball. He was kind of pushing that ball.
Yeah. Maybe force that one a bit.
Yeah, just a bit. He hasn't been like that. He's been patient.
Not sure if you could hear the score being called. It's 2-5-1. Ernesto and Matthew trail. Rob, Aspen.
There we go. You know, I just feel like these guys are a little bit tired. I mean, this is a little bit of a slow start here for these two. I mean, they were playing at such an accelerated level earlier.
And that's not uncommon to see that, actually. They come off a big win. They need to regroup here, but they'll get going.
It's a lot of pickleball they've played today. A lot of high-intensity pickleball. Wow, good hands from Matthew right there.
Yeah, Matthew, that was really... And he's been doing that. That's what he's been doing all day today.
He's so crisp with it.
He got that paddle back up into position so quickly. Expecting the counter.
And by the way, Matthew's impressed a lot of people today. I don't think people really know Matthew well enough to see this level, right?
The whole family's impressed.
Yeah.
Especially Matthew.
Well, Matthew's won a lot of tournaments with his sister.
Jessica, I think it's
Jessica. Yeah, Jessica Calamoto. Yep.
Good reset there.
No, you're going to start seeing his name more often. Trust me.
Really, both of these guys. Ernesto's a phenomenal player as well. There's Bob Cassidy bringing out what he does best, too.
Well, Rob prides himself on his defense. Being able to retrieve a lot of those balls. He's got super quick hands.
You don't see that very often. You got it. That's
you hardly ever see him miss a server return.
He's just so steady, right? Mm-hmm. That's what Matthew's been really great at.
He's improved a tremendous amount in the last 12 months.
Yeah. That's a great shot.
Change direction with it.
Yeah, because Aspen looks like he's going to be dinking right there, and all of a sudden he just fires straight.
It looked like he was going to go cross court with a heavy slice and just flicked it back the other direction, right up under Ernesto's chin.
Yeah, no, really good point. I mean, the interesting about this, Rob is the one that's bringing the power to this game, right? The rest of them, he's the wild card right now.
He is the wild card. He's always the wild card.
Yeah.
Perfect timing.
Well, they're not playing Aspen all of a sudden because Aspen beat them all.
Absolutely, they
but
don't want
Rob's
to take
no slacker. That you go at either one of these guys right now.
Well, it is interesting. It's almost as if Ernesto and Matthew wanted to give Matthew a chance to trust his hands up against Rob's. A couple of boxers duking it out with some quick jabs. See who can win that contest.
Yeah, and actually, that's funny you should say that. I think the strategy would be to change that up a little bit. I would have them go across from each other at this point in time. And I might take Ernesto and have him go across Kern for that backhand.
You know, that's a good point.
You know, and I haven't seen them do that, but at this point they're getting beat with Kern's slice, right? It's just taking them out of position.
You don't see Ernesto and Matthew in your screen right now. Talking at length. strategizing. You can see them pointing, trying to figure out what their next move is. Whereas Rob and Aspen were kind of content to keep to themselves.
That's interesting. They're still wanting Matthew to go against Kern, and that's just kind of a surprise to me. I think.
Wow. I think they want Matthew up against Rob.
Yeah. See how they've softened up against Rob there? They're not letting Rob have the firepower that he's had.
Yeah. You can keep it. Maybe take a little pace off and keep it down at your opponent's feet. That's usually a good idea. Just missed wide on that.
Oh, it was definitely an inch and a half out. For Rob to think it was close was kind of funny.
Well, is Rob being funny?
No, he was serious, but he should have been funny.
I thought it was a good call to me. Unfortunately, because of the camera angle, we won't be able to replay it that way down.
Yeah, I don't think you'll be able to see that one too well in the video.
If I had the budget, I'd have a camera on every corner, but.
Heavy slice back here.
That's a great one.
See if they can reset it.
They will. They will watch. This is really their strength right here. Look at this.
Got it. Yeah. They're done. Call the DJ.
Watched them all day today. They've been great at doing that. Look, see, this is what I want. This is what I think is good and powerful.
This is the setup that EJ was suggesting. Put Matthew in front of Aspen. Ernesto cross court from Aspen. Or Ernesto can maybe handle some of those things. Got it.
Oh!
Kidding me.
That's
good pickleball. I think I closed my eyes, Scott. Yes, I saw it.
Sorry,
it was amazing.
I was a little loud on that. I just couldn't believe it.
Turn your volume down at home. Six, 6'8", 2.
There he goes, yep.
Ernesto had an opportunity, went for it, and just mishit it, dumped it in the net. 8-6-1. Again, another third shot, drop falling short.
Yeah.
Haven't seen a lot of high ones today. I think it's the ball. That ball's been falling short over and over and over again. It decelerates so fast. I've seen so many good players drop
DJ,
that ball too
folks
short.
I don't know about that, but yeah, there's no question the gamma ball is such a softer ball that the players are so used to a Dura and a much harder ball, right?
It's lighter too. Lighter.
You really got to push through this ball. That's a big reason why you're seeing a lot of these fast exchanges too, because the ball will decelerate just enough that the opponent can get a paddle on it, rip it right back.
That's a great observation.
One more short third ball. The trick is not overcompensating. You want to hit it too hard. Put that ball up in your opponent's strike zone too often. That's not good either.
Wow, yeah, that's a rare.
That ball skipped, yeah.
That ball did shoot on him a little bit.
Yeah, that's rare.
It's what you call an anomaly.
He wasn't firing back on that.
But you see Ernesto's hands? I mean, they are so far out in front of him, right? He's just reactionary. Boom. Power.
Well, he got caught a couple times earlier.
Yeah, good point.
But he was ready that time.
Oh, that shot by Bob. Bob kind of put it up in an awkward spot right there for Matthew.
Difficult.
You expect more pace on that ball.
A loft speed pitch. Got that one.
Look at that.
Well, quickness. Well, Matthew initiated that.
Yes, good point.
I don't think he's afraid to go toe-to-toe with Rob Cassidy.
Not one bit. He believes in his hands as much as anybody
else. There's not too many players you can say that about, though.
I agree.
Rob got the better of Matthew that time. Well, you know, it is good. It's an interesting matchup. They both have extremely quick hands. And neither man wants to back down from the other. Players just want to make sure, and they're professionals, but they want to make sure it doesn't become personal.
Scores 8-7-2.
I like this matchup. Rob's so far getting the upper hand on that straight across.
I really want to see that switched up. I got to tell you, I thought they had it much better when they switched it up.
It looked more natural.
It did. I just don't understand. We're not seeing it. That's the thing.
That's called a shake and bake right there. Shake and bake.
Well, Aspen Kern purposefully sped up that third ball, hoping to get that reply up in the air just a little bit so Rob Cassidy could slide over and punish that ball.
It's been 7-2, by the way. Match point here.
Game point.
Game point.
Game one.
Thank you, DJ.
Played best 2 out of 3 here, Scott Golden.
Like I said, you're never afraid to call me out.
And like I said, it's all in good fun, buddy.
100%.
So explain to me a little bit. I mean, you're sitting with Matthew right now, and they're going back and forth, and they're playing Matthew. Why is he not making a few more ATP attempts? He's not giving him any shot to make him a little nervous at this
it's
point.
It's not his style. Okay. That's why he just doesn't. That's not what he's thinking about doing.
I haven't seen too many that have been that clear.
But no, to his point, I think that Matthew's quick enough to be able to play those off. But he's just not doing it.
No, let's clarify. Are you talking earning attempts or around the post?
I mean, sorry, earning attempts.
Okay, that makes sense.
I knew exactly what you meant.
Thank you.
It's an earning attempt. I think it's just
to get him off guard.
You have to set your mindset to that type of setup. Yeah. And he just doesn't set that mindset to that. Like,
see,
Rob keeps it on that. Your mindset's always to do that.
But my thought was, if Matthew just does it a couple times, it's just going to get him thinking about it.
At least pose the threat.
Right? Exactly. And it's not in his mind.
You know who does it better than anybody in our sport? It's Tyler.
Tyler's got a great
Ernie. Well said.
He does it in singles like most people would do it in doubles.
He just leaps 5 miles. I mean, what the heck?
He's a gazelle.
Got it.
Wow. The other person is actually like that is Navratil, you know, Zane. It just is like flying around that post at the same type of pace, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
somebody
Zane does it.
Tell them about here.
So one thing I want to just bring up real quick is that it may be throwing Matthew off a little bit being straight across from Rob because Rob's a lefty. So I noticed he's at some point when they get into those firefights, the ball's kind of going up to what would normally be a backhand for a righty. Now it's Rob's forehand, and he's pulling that ball hard back there. We saw it 3 or 4 times that last second half. So I'm wondering if they need to go back, like you said, to putting Ernesto straight across. You know what I mean? I think that could be part of the issue. I really do think that Matthew's struggling with the lefty. He's not used to seeing Rob with the left-handed right there. It's different. It really is.
I just wonder if Ernesto will actually – I don't know how well they know each other.
It will be interesting to see.
Advice at this stage of the game.
I mean, what do you like when you're watching that? Do you see that a lefty? It changes the dynamic of the shot.
In my opinion, I think that Ernesto handles the dinks that come from Aspen with that slice approach more casually. It doesn't take him way out of position.
Yeah,
he barely has to move from it. When he does it to Matt's backing up.
Yeah.
I agree. Getting out of position.
And I think it looked more natural to have Aspen and Ernesto cross court. That's the Cassidy kid right there, joining us live.
Keeping it light.
Hey, our view. Hey.